the neuron center can generate more thought. Then, based on how many programs you have in that neuron center, how many programs you have for that computer, the computer can be smarter or dumber. And then once it kicks in, it's joined, just like with the cable, to other computers or other neuron centers. So the whole key is this. The neuron, wherever it is found, is capable of generating or processing thought. That's all you have to know. And if you doubt me, go look up in your physiology books tonight, come out tomorrow, and we'll talk about it. If you understand and agree with me, let us move on. Anywhere you have a neuron that is linked to other neurons or to the spine or to nerve centers, that means that neuron can function. What is a neuron supposed to do? Generate and process thoughts coming and going. You have a collection of neurons up and down your spine and in certain pockets throughout the body, one of which is called the solar plexus. And just a little bit below it, above the spleen and above the navel, you will have a neuron center. That, I claim, is your animal brain location. That is why in the Oriental philosophy, in the Yoruba philosophy, even amongst the ancient Zulus, concentration upon the solar plexus with energies coming in either from the moon or the sun will turn a person more like into an animal than before. You can act like an animal and still be human because you are an animal person. Most of your ideas of survival, hunger, fear, fighting, come generated from that selection of neurons at the solar plexus. They do not come from that up here in the skull. In fact, you will find when you get really uptight, what did they say? My stomach got in knots, I couldn't talk, I just felt pain here and I was all uptight. That is your animal brain talking, taking over to fight or flight, to fear or love, to hate or to detest. These are all animal passions, and that's why they call them. These are the emotional hubs. They say that we use less than 1% of our brain. I sometimes even question that amount. The reason why we don't is because we are usually ruled by the animal body, an animal brain, which has got so used to dominating man that now man is more animal in many cases than, what can I say, some of the animals. Some of the animals will not kill in the way man will now kill, or human will kill. Animals in general will fight to a point where one gives up, turns belly up, and the animal growls, postures, and walks away. Man will blow you away, human will blow you away now for no reason at all. We have become more animals. And therefore, those sections of our neuron centers work better than the one up here. So much here, this thing up here has nothing to do, it's getting rusty. It gets a lot of mucus around it. Its ends burn out and it won't fire correctly. You begin to really try to use it, you get a headache. You use it even more, you begin to get boils and breakouts because the energy has to drive out the pus and stuff that is coagulating the machinery. We don't use it. And there has been a lot of interest to stop us from using it, especially those of the sons of God and their offspring. Why? Because mankind and human was taught by mankind that if ever the sons of God would awaken to the power of using the upper brain power, they would become so devastating, so frighteningly auspicious, that everything on earth would tremble at the power of this latent god and giant now asleep. That's why they've never told you the proper use of the brain, and they will tell you again also that the pineal gland is an atrophied, non-usable tissue, an organ that used to function but now has no bearing. That's another one of the biggest lies ever told. The pineal gland generates melanin and melatonin. It works best between the hours of 11 at night and 2 in the morning, when most of you should be asleep or in total darkness. It does not like light during the time it is regenerating. And that is also when most of the sons of God will find that 3 days out of the month, or either in the evening or daytime, you have to find out whether you are a solar being or a moon frequency being. I know you don't know what I mean yet. Keep coming and we'll talk. That means at that time, the hole at the roof of your mouth will begin to let out air. It will begin to generate a little bubbling sound. Some of us have not even understood when this happens. It usually has a pattern, and as you become more and more conscious of it and do things to increase it, it will open up more and more. How many of you, now don't lie about it, share with me, I'd like to see again the consciousness here, men, because they say, women, you don't have this privilege or this curse, whichever, your day is tomorrow. Men have found that sometimes they seem to feel air or bubbling at the roof of their mouth in the area I just had you to try and trace with your tongue. How many have noticed it sometimes active, but you never knew when it was? Just two, three, four, some of you are thinking about it. And you often say, boy, what was that? And it sounded like a little bubbling sound. Sometimes it might even go on for 30 seconds, which is very frightening. You say, what the heck was that? That is our King's Chamber and the Grand Gallery leading to that. Sorry about that. Leading to that passageway, trying to again work, trying to energize itself. Something you did kicked it in a little bit. I state through meditation, I state through honoring the pineal gland by sleeping during those hours. You don't even have to sleep much past that if you can get good sleep during that time. It will increase the degree and vibration of the melatonin that you have in your body, increase your psychic power, so-called, your sense of ESP, and your health will increase. Once more, as when the sons of God came here and committed the atrocity that lowered the potential of man, and yet it was a blessing because it gave a seed and a spark to mankind that he could never have had otherwise. So it was both a curse and a benefit. When they came here, our planet was surrounded by a magnetic field. That magnetic field cloaked out gamma rays and other what they call cosmic rays from coming into our planet and disrupting the life progression that was on the surface of our planet. These same Lord gods then came and set up an electrical field inside that magnetic field, causing everything to slow down. Now they refer to it as Earth's electromagnetic field, or simply the Van Allen radiation belt. It is full of negative radiation, just like an atomic bomb or Chernobyl was full of negative radiation, which is harmful to grazing consciousness, to getting in the higher vibrations once more into our Earth. It was put up there as a frequency barrier by purpose by Lord Gods, who for a time sought to dominate this planet and tried to misuse again the seed of the angels who had committed adultery here, but also had given a soul a chance to migrate and progress here in a form that normally was not used. Let me simply break it down by saying this. For close to 5 million years, the sons of God have degenerated on this planet. Their souls have come and gone in bodies, never opening up to what and who they really were, only from time to time getting a little light into what they potentially were supposed to be. Once they were not able to call on directly the universal cosmic creator, they had to then accept false gods and false teachings by mankind, who was put upon the earth later on by others to keep this Son of God in control. From greatness and grandeur, having the bloodline of the angels, they also had the higher frequency body potential of the angels. But now it was locked in an animal body and could only escape between the hours of 11 and 2 in the morning, when the pineal gland could kick in and they could come out of these false bodies and become what they really were. That's why people who dream in black and white are on the verge of ascending. People who dream in color and remember the dreams and have dreams that come in threes are prophets. And as it moves up again, they can begin to awaken and come outside of your body, look down upon your body, and see that you are more than the body, because you never were human. You were simply encased in human and locked in by the frequency barrier, and you didn't know who you were. Trapped on a planet who you didn't even come from, were only here for a lesson, the lesson has got to go on and on and on infinitum, or even the planet is getting tired of that now and is changing the frequency. what we are.